when you and I first met a few years ago, you had an idea and a concept. Now you have a company moving forward with it. I think actually as a start, let's explain why having that degree of interaction with what is a robotic arm in that lab environment through natural language is necessary. What is it solved for?
Yeah, so we want to give scientists directly, not just engineers, but scientists directly, the ability to actually run experiments at scale. And that is why we are building the physical AI scientist, physical AI that allows them to automate their scientific experiments at scale, and also the AI scientist, so they can talk to it, they can co-pilot design experiments with this AI scientist.
What is it that you bring that others haven't in terms of the physical AI? Is it your data that's paramount to none? Is it the fact that your scientists are paramount to none? Is it the technology? What is it?
It is all of those things and more. Industrial automation has been the key way that life sciences has automated their labs, but we are seeing a huge paradigm shift across every industry that is using robotics, where industries are shifting away from industrial automation to physical AI. And that is also what Medra is bringing to life science, the ability to flexibly automate their lab experiments instead of using brittle lab automation technologies from before.
I want to think about this and I review the photos and images. I hope we have some images to share with our audience. I think a little bit about Tony Stark and Jarvis. It's the idea that there is an artificial intelligence that one interacts with through the robotic mechanism. When we first spoke, and this a long time ago now, this was about like efficiency. Like labs are difficult environments. It's hard to move around them. It takes physical strength and time to, you know. But $52 million, a lot of money, you know, you just click your fingers and you can suddenly do it. You've solved it.
No, I mean, we have so much more to be building because, again, it's not just about automating the work, but about this idea. Can we automate science itself? Can we have a scientific AI that can reason about the science, generate hypotheses, design experiments? And when we actually run the experiments with our physical AI, once that data is generated, can we take that data and then can we think about what are the new optimizations and changes necessary to make that science better?
We started the conversation by introducing this as in the context of drug development, other life science fields. What is the industry there and therefore your customer?
Yeah, so we are working with some of the leading biopharma companies, including Genentech, to help them use our technology to really create this lab in the loop idea. And we are working with some of the best machine learning teams at our customers, where their machine learning teams can then propose new experiments they want to run, new ideas they want to test. And then again, our physical AI scientists can take those ideas, those predictions, and turn that into data that then feeds back into their machine learning models.
This $52 million, where is it going to be spent most predominantly? Talent? Marketing? What?
All of those, again, all of those above. We are growing our team and expanding our team across engineering, robotics, AI, hardware, software, and also on operations and go-to-market. We're expanding partnerships with other biopharma companies. And also, we will be building our own lab. We'll be opening up an autonomous lab with 100 robots next year to be able to run experiments and generate data at scale.
Do you think the U.S. is leading here, Michelle?
We want to be leading, and Medra is going to be that force that helps the U.S. lead in this area.